At Vyapt, power of our purpose drives us. What truly matters today is kindness, love, generosity, and oneness. Today, what we really want is each other and to tell each other that I'm here for you and I care for you. To celebrate simple things in life, one smile brings an entire future from funnel of darkness to history full of success. It's not so much the conditions of our life that control our destiny as much as decisions of our life. At Vyapt, we are committed to give the most basic dimensions of mankind hope and love. Our growth series is inspired by numerous people who are celebrating spirit of mankind through their dedicated service. And at Vyapt, we are celebrating it by sharing growth prospects and opportunities in different sectors through various leaders. In Vyapt's growth series today, we have with us Mr. Ranjit Singh, who is the CEO chemical business at Kanoria Chemicals and Industries Limited. Ranjit, with around 3 decades of experience, has been instrumental through his contribution in various organizations. Welcome, Ranjit.
Thank you.
Ranjit, we have our first curiosity with you. Is how do you see the growth of chemical business in India in the next 2 quarters and what are its challenges?
So I'll go a little in detail, like what is the terminology. Chemical is there in everything what we use, starting from agrochemical, automobile, packaging, paints, or whatever, food and feed, everywhere that is there. And Indian chemical industry is so large that it's the 6th largest in the world and 3rd largest in the Asia. If you see India in the export and import, chemical sector comes in the top 3 or 4 numbers. So we are so big in that. Apart from that, if you see in India, the consumption of chemical in India is almost 1/10 of the global average. And if you see, today government is working on 5 trillion economy. That is possible only when chemical sector will reach 1 trillion. So 20% of the Indian GDP has to come from the industry. In the technical term, we say the TRS, total return on stakeholders. So Indian chemical industry TRS is 15% against global average of 8%. Indian chemical industry is big, it's vibrant, it's value-adding. Yes, we can see some challenges in short term, but long term our growth story is perfectly very bullish. Specific to next 2 quarters, as I said, that is a little challenge, but things are coming from the domestic demand. India demand is going to increase for the chemical sector. Mainly now demands are coming from the rural India. We are saying India average is 1/10 of the global demand, then rural sector is much below that. So that is going to come. Exports, because globally nowadays there is a conflict, India, China, and the global conflict, people are partying with some countries or not. So export requirements for the Indian chemical, especially specialty chemical, is coming from the new territories, new countries. Okay. One of the benchmark is that you see the share prices in the stock exchange. Okay. You see most of the chemical companies' stocks are almost close to 52-week high. But in pandemic, industry, customer, and the people who are investing in them, they can see future, you know, the brighter future come now. Other thing is that India, in last 2 years, we have made a lot of investment in sustainability. Business has to be very sustainable. A lot of effluent, water, and everything is there. It will be a news for the industry that one of the very prestigious achievement is a responsible care logo, where we don't say only that we are compliant to the norms of the industry, we are much more than that. So in India, 64 chemical companies has already been awarded with RC logo. So all these are going in the direction where we are going to grow very fast. one. Similarly, on the feedstock, which is a concern for India, Indian industry, you see, mergers and acquisitions and joint ventures are going on, like Aramco and Reliance. Yes, all this is being done to secure feedstock for the chemical industry. That is on the growth part. If you see the challenges for Indian chemical industry is the economy of scale. We don't have that. Our reason for that, we don't have feedstock, and the other reason, like, we don't have infrastructure. But economy of scale is a challenge for us. We don't have that. Other thing is that, like, it's not there in so much there in other sector, but in chemical industry, skill set availability is very bad. The reason is that the way we used chemical as the terminology, that is not good. We will find that people are not opting for the chemical industry engineering as their choice of subject.
Okay.
Because it is, another thing is that it is said that if you are a chemical engineer, you have to remain in the shop floor to observe. It is not there. Skill set for the chemical industry, though we are working very closely with the institution and trying to make it up, the other thing is the last thing what we can see in last 3 months is the financials. Banks are reluctant to finance MSP sectors. It is a majority part of the chemical industry. The 3-4 challenges what we can find.
You vividly talk about the kind of challenges the industry is facing, but can you also talk about the major opportunities this pandemic has brought for chemical business in India, and what transformations are required to excel in this changing landscape?
This is a good question. So I'll again go back to the terminology. Like, what we are saying is that today in pandemic season, we are saying that people will focus to healthy lifestyle. The moment you say healthy lifestyle, chemical come into the play. We see a big business, but the moment you say that you are going to live a healthy lifestyle, start from cleaning, sanitizing, or packaging, name the sector. For a healthy lifestyle, chemical is there. That is a big opportunity for us. Even we see the opportunity in lockdown. Like, in lockdown, everybody is facing a feeling that there has to be some different furniture requirement is there, because we want a workstation at home also. So furniture sector uses a lot of chemicals from the construction chemical. So such a big opportunity that new investment has started coming looking into that furniture requirement. In the southern part, like Andhra Pradesh and that sector. So if you see in last 2 months, we have got inquiries from, so many new countries, not only customers, but new countries, we have got the requirements. It's going to create very good. Other thing I said that demand now, if you can see the agriculture is going to grow, so demand is coming from the rural sector. Rural sector being very low on the chemical, that is what. In the next 3-4 months, we see boom in the requirement of chemicals from the companies who are catering to the rural sector. Other thing is that opportunity for us is that for long we were talking that Western companies have done digitization and analytical DNA, we say. In the chemical sector, that digitization was not there. I'll tell you that in chemical industry, a large number of companies have worked in these 2 months for digitization. How that is going to help is sure shot, is proven that it will improve your productivity, it will improve your operating cost, it will automatically improve your sustainability.
So true.
These 2 months, chemical company has utilized in managing that DNA. Number of people we are going to have, there are restrictions in number of people who are going to attend the office. So, use that. So that is also going to help us very well. So those are opportunity I can see in next 3-4 months, which is going to come to India. transformation is a is will come to the basics of that, that we need to have economy of scale. How it is going to help you is that you get into a new geography, you get into new customer segment. Mm-hmm. To help, you are not dependent on particular country or particular customer segment. Mm-hmm. Other thing is that when you go global, you have alternate supply sources for your feedstock. Mm-hmm. You have option to have a alternate technology what you are using, because India needs technology also. Mm-hmm. The thing is that what we have also done is that integration of value chain, like a company acquired the raw material supplier company. Mm-hmm. Backward integration. Likewise, one of the company, because he has the 70% share with the one customer, so he acquired that customer company. Mm-hmm. So in integration, that is also, it will all will come with economy of scale. You are big, you can think big, you can do big. Mm-hmm. Other thing what I can see is that in India is that environmental sustainability. So if you see Indian companies, there are three concern factors: energy, water, and effluent. Mm. So on these three, we need to work very hard. We need to go a long way the way Western companies and large multinationals are going. Mm. So this is the area where we need a totally transformation. Mm. Because in India chemical sector, a lot of MSMEs are there. Mm. So not that much of concern about the environmental thing than the big company. Third thing I would say, the government policy. Mm-hmm. See, we are saying that chemical sector is growing very fast. Mm-hmm. What world is looking at you is that 135, 137 crore people, fastest growing economy, major economy, and they are looking you as a market. Mm-hmm. But you want to cater the global economy. Mm-hmm. So there is a difference in what market thinks about you and how you want to go around.
Correct.
So today when we are talking of that, okay, China is in that advantage is going to come and red carpet, I will tell you, here government plays a lot of role. Like we say that small ticket investment, small ticket when we say that $250 million, mm-hmm. that investment will come because of the strength of Indian companies. Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. Infrastructure. Mm-hmm. But you talk of a big ticket investment more than $1 billion or $2 billion, $3 billion, those investment they see ROI of 10 years. Mm-hmm. Stability in your policy. Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. The reason if you see in last 20 years, not much of the big ticket investment has come into chemical sector. Mm-hmm. So government need to work on that. They need to address it sector level, like what is required for feedstock, there has to be more feedstock. What is required for skill set, what is required for infrastructure like PCPIR, mm-hmm. is required for environment. So they, as an industry, they need not to focus. Now they need to work on that particular sector level, prioritize. Mm-hmm. Government demand. Other thing for skill, I said that industry and academia has to work very closely. We need to have a pipeline of the people, otherwise in next 5 years chemical industry is going to face a problem.
Okay.
You see what we have a lot is that 15 year plus experience people are there in the chemical industry. Mm-hmm. Two lots are not coming. Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. I think what, because India has got a chemical industry, has got a lot of MSMEs. Mm-hmm. To support, like these companies cannot have their own R&D setup and product innovation setup. Mm-hmm. But need to help them in having a common like ICT Indian
from where they can access the information. Yeah.
So they can give their job to them. Professors, research associates are working on that. They can give their job to them. Mm-hmm. Give to them, they will charge. Mm-hmm. They need not to hire, because they are reluctant to hire 10 PhDs to work on that, because they don't find, see that, okay, with this project we'll include the company. So they should work on that.
Correct.
The transformation, these 3-4 transformations I can see, we need to work on urgently.
When you're so optimistic about the kind of growth we will be seeing in the chemical industry, what kind of employment prospects can we see as we see the growth opportunities in this segment?
See, chemical industry, if you say, as I told you, such a big industry, you know, chemical industry in India, chemical industry, 80,000 manufacturing units are there. 80,000. Mm-hmm. And our, we say, factory overhead, that is direct factory overhead plus indirect factory overhead, that is 10% of the cost of the product. That is a highly manpower intensive sector. Mm-hmm. That too also in that, when we come to specialty chemical, because not much of technology is involved, more and more of manpower involvement is there. So, talking average of 10% of the factory overhead cost, if you see in a specialty chemical, it will be around 15 to 18%. So, that is the, I would say that there we see that manpower intensive chemical industry, if that is going to grow, demand for additional manpower is going to grow. That is why we are now more concerned about the skill set, because we are not finding the replacement. Those people who are retiring from our system, we are finding it difficult to find the match for that. So, chemical industry per se is a huge employer of the manpower, both labor force as well as skilled manpower. Like, there is a technology called zero liquid discharge for effluent that can be run only by specialized people. What we do today is that we run that ZLD, zero liquid discharge facility with a general technician. At the same time, we have not given concentrated on giving the standardized training to these our existing people. So there is, industry is also responsible for that, for getting the right skill set. Other than that, that I said that digitization is very low. Our sector is so vast that if one particular sector will go down, the other sector will support the industry. So growth is going to continue. So employment opportunity, that is going to happen.
So when you talk about this, about employment opportunities, and we also saw Ranjit talking about and motivating youngsters to pursue chemical engineering and other courses on chemical engineering. Something very personal to you, you know, what advice would you like to share with your experience in dealing with adversities?
Adversity, I mean, we can group into small problems and the big adversities like COVID we have, or 2008-09, that global meltdown was there. So I'll try and make it in two parts. One is that what as an individual you should do, as a leader you should. As an individual, it's very, very important that keep yourself healthy to cope up with the stress. I recommend that eat the best healthy food, do exercise, yoga, everything. Keep you physically and mentally fit to cope with the stress, because it's all unknown. You don't know where, from where it will come and what you're going to face today if you're going to the office. Another thing, on the personal individual level, I'll recommend that you should be surrounded with the positive people and the people who are smarter. It's going to help you personally. If you're surrounded with the negative people and dull people, so it's going to add to your panic. And the third thing is that without losing focus on your task, stay focused on the task. These things treat as if it has come and it will go. So you focus on the task, remain there. The other thing, when we are saying as a leader, we need to think on the skill development. Need to have multi-skill people. In Corona times, we have made a team A, B and C. One person is infected, the whole team has to be quarantined.
Correct.
So, if you say in QC, one team, one person got infected, the whole QC team has gone. Have a people in production who have a skill of testing and doing QC, he will replace that person. A production person got infected, the QC people, not with the same skill set, but he will be able to run the show. skill set, multi-skill is very important. Another thing is the communication for the leader. Should communicate at all levels. All time you generally communicate with your immediate reportees, or in all kind of meeting you talk to young people at large. But communication, frequent communication is very important. Request them for the Kaizen, because new thing, new ideas will come from the people at down level, those are at the soft floor. As a leader, you need to be again focused on your target. Your goal. Because why I'm saying that, you need to stay calm. You are supposed to think differently. You suggest coming up with the 10 options, but you have to find an 11th option. So you need to be thinking that way, that you stay calm. One of the things personal to me, which I would say, that always believe that your best is yet to come. Try and delegate the job in this pandemic, because a lot of things will come as a firefighting.
So you were very bullish in the in terms of growth of this segment, and now you also showcased a very natural leadership style, wherein you are talking about delegation, and you are also talking about sharing communication, not only at the top level, but at with everybody in the organization. You know, the kind of experience you shared, that's really nice. I would like to have only one liner from you, with the kind of humbleness you carry, the humility you carry for the people you have. Can you something? Can you tell me something more about your background? From where you come from, the kind of values and culture you have, which has kept you more humble, which has kept you down to earth, even in such a leadership role.
I come from a very holy city, which is Banaras.
Okay.
So there are things, mythological thing, cultural thing, that is inbuilt in my personality. And after doing my post-graduation in management from IIM Calcutta, and as a typical management graduate, as a management trainee, one organization which is SRF Limited. That organization is culturally very strong and very systematic organization. There I learned all the basics, all the basics of the trade I learned there. Humility, which I, if you find in me, it all has come from that organization, where people were at the top priority for the company. Everything was of second. I come from that background. I moved to a company called Jubilant, which is a master company in execution. If world can execute any project in 3 years, Jubilant can do it in 2.5 years. So that kind of execution. So then I learned the execution. So mix of that, six, and the execution, that has helped me to take up the job at Kanoria Chemical as a CEO. There to work on the both the fronts, where a challenge for delivering as well as challenge for keeping the people motivated to deliver the best. So mix of that has helped me to do that.
So a saying goes like this: if you're good, the world is good for you. So that stands true for Ranjit. Very profound perspectives, and it was so wonderful interacting with you, Ranjit. Thank you so much for being with us in our growth series.
Thanks a lot. Thank you.